thing, but the congressman, let me ask you to respond to Councilman Stokes. Do you think that calling the bad actors last night thugs is the equivalent of the N-word?
Let me just do something here, because it's important we not shift the focus into something that has absolutely nothing to do with poverty, despair, hunger, homelessness, and a sense of not belonging. That's what this is coming out of. So whether we call him a thug, a lawbreaker, a juvenile delinquent, it really doesn't matter. What matters is, how do we take back our streets? And that's what men have been doing, going around talking to these young men where they are, in their face, and letting them know, you can't control this community. It is not yours. You can't burn it down. You can't force people out. You can't threaten people. So I understand that, if people want to talk about a word, but I'm more worried about a movement. And it's not necessarily a movement for positive change. It's a movement for negative change right now, unless we get it under control.
Councilman, in terms of the mother that got a lot of attention, and I know you know this, you've seen this picture, after the video captured her berating her son for participating in the protests. She spoke to CBS about why she was seen hitting her child, which is what she was doing. She's telling him not to do it, but she was doing it by hitting him. Here's what she said to CBS.
Lo and behold, I turn around and I look in this crowd, and my son is actually coming across the street with this hoodie on and a mask. At that point, I just lost it. That's my only son. And at the end of the day, I don't want him to be a Freddie Gray.
Now, Councilman, what's your response to that? I mean, you know, you see her trying to do the right thing. Of course, she's doing it by being very violent against her son. What's your reaction to what she did?
Was this a violent? Yeah, I don't know.
Go ahead.
It's violent. I mean, she's trying to tell him,
you don't get angry. I will grab your head. Now, that's violence. Maybe that's necessary violence. And a lot of brothers are reacting that way. And a lot of us grew up with that, so you didn't make the same mistake twice. But she is doing what she has to do out there in the street to remind her son that he is her son, that she is his mother, and she won't tolerate it. So I know for some people it might say, oh my God, she hit him. Yeah, she hit him, because she's trying to make him understand that she loves him and she doesn't want him out there.
And Councilman, what should police be doing?
Save his life.
Go ahead. Yeah, go ahead, Councilman, sir.
What I was going to say, if he was trying to save his life, it is clear that it's better that she hit him than the police hit him and brutalize him and take his life from him.
All right. Well, I appreciate both of your time very much tonight. Thank you very much. A very provocative conversation. Next, as we've got now 2,000 National Guard troops ready here in Baltimore. Another 1,000 police are on the streets of Baltimore. Protesters are gathering.